I do not know if anybody older than me in this audience. I'm 83 years old. So I just want to say that in my first 21 years, I was dreaming. And that was the time when I was in IIT Kharagpur, got the degree in naval architecture, joined the Navy with all the enthusiasm to learn the art of warship building and warship design. So 4 years studies in UK and came back with lots of enthusiasm. And fortunately, as we've been talking earlier also, Indian Navy, which is highly technical service, they understood the requirement of the engineers and technologists in uniform. And fortunately, this is being in part of the uniform, Indian Navy has taken the shape of building its own designing and building own ships. Now, very interesting, as I said, the first 20, 22 years I dreamt, then I was all enthusiasm. I presented a paper in 1978 on research and development for indigenous shipbuilding. People were talking, he's talking out of blue, you know, what will be research and development requirement. Then I implemented that again through the Navy, so that era has gone, and R&D facility, Naval Science and Technological Laboratory. Ladies and gentlemen, who are here, professional will not know, but they are the one of the best of its kind in the world. You know, the towing tank particularly, cavitation tunnel, then maneuvering basin, they are the state of the art, the one of the best in the world. Now, Admiral Dhawan is not here. I would like to want, you know, that everybody to coordinate the various resources what we have got in the country, then pass it on to others for use. We are talking about Visakhapatnam to set up a R&D center. R&D center exists, but is the facility utilized? Anyway, cutting this story short, I am in the fag end of my life. So I am now giving thought about ship recycling, graveyard. You see, you have talked about ship design, ship building, shipping. Now everybody must also think like the, you know, the cycle. One day we'll all close our eyes. Similarly, ship will come to an end. You have to think how to recycle the ship. Now, as you know, India is perhaps the largest shipbreaking facility, you know, the business going, you know, in Alang and some few other places also. Pakistan had been doing it. Bangladesh is also taking a very good position. But are they state of the art? So here, are you? Thank you. So 33% of the total volume of the world ship recycling is taking place in India. India is among the three top countries, as I mentioned, was India, Bangladesh, and China also is significant. And the latest entry was Turkey. Now, there was a Hong Kong convention which brought out how to make the green, you know, ship recycling, environmental pollution, you know, the various NGO organizations in the world, and they were all questioning India's way of doing the ship recycling. Now, India's population, you know, about 30,000 odd people are employed, and there's not one, you know, 11 kilometers of coastline in Alang, where there are about 150 yards. They are all average, you know, they are breaking about 2 to 3 ships in a year. So about more than 400 ships are broken, recycled, you know, in Alang. Now, I'm running a consultancy organization, Consulting Engineering Services, that is CSIST Engineering India Private Limited. Now, one gentleman from Kenya in Mombasa, he was dreaming that he will have ship recycling and it has to be state of the art. So he was trying to bring me into the subject, but his way of doing business didn't agree with it. So we parted. He gave the task to the Dutch consultancy team, and they gave a feasibility report, which he said, no, this will not work. It's only the Indians who can give some innovative ideas and commercially viable idea. So his respect was more towards the Indian way of thinking. So again, I was pulled in. So I said, Mr. So-and-so, if you agree to my terms, then only I can come and see. So he said, no, I'm sending you the business air ticket and all that. You must come and, you know, discuss with me and hold my hand. So I accepted it anyway. So the project at the moment is in the state of takeoff, in the sense the project implementation stage. Now I will just show my next slides. I mentioned about this Hong Kong Convention. While doing this project, Commander Deval, my director of operation, I told him that you get yourself thoroughly conversant with this convention. What are the requirements? What are the document? Very involved documentation auditing is required. So he is also undergoing a sort of Lloyd's training on the subject. And Lloyd's Register of Shipping, they came forward and they say, yes, we'll check your design and we'll also audit while the project is on. Now, all these ship recycling yards which I mentioned, they are all only cutting the ship, breaking the ship, and, you know, the various components are disposed of. Though the Hong Kong, according to Hong Kong Convention, GMB in Gujarat, then Lloyd's, they are also checking. But no organization or no establishment exists which is in totality. In other words, you not only scrap the steel, but you make steel and, you know, finish it. This gentleman from Kenya, he dreamed that. So he brought in, and I said, I am a shipman. What do I know about the steel making? You know, no, you are from an institute where you got all the technologists and your network is very vast and you will bring in. So my organization had to take this task also. So we have created a facility. And as I say that you need not go for all those, what I have given here on the slide. I now come back to what is the process which we have thought about. We are doing a project for a strategic purpose, Mazagon Dock, where we were required to do a launching facility, and also that facility was also for retrieval. So I said that if we can design something for 4,000 tons, why not for 30,000 or 35,000 tons? A light ship of VLCC or Cape size, you can talk about, you know, anywhere about 22,000 tons to 30,000 tons or 35,000 tons. So here it is nothing but this the roll-on and roll-off. So you are rolling on to the ship when you are launching. So it occurred to me that Korea, suddenly they have to increase their shipbuilding capacity. The infrastructure cost is very high if you have, and particularly this kind of long ships, launching is very cumbersome job. And dry dock building is very, very expensive because you are not, you know, the infrastructure cost is very high. So they were the innovators where they brought in this specific type of design of floating docks. They transferred the ship, which is totally built on board, on the shop floor, and rolled onto the ship. And then these floating docks were taken into deep water, sunk, and the ship was floated out. So this technology was available in Korea. So I said, I take the reverse process. Pick up a floating dock, which we can, we are also designer of floating docks. So floating dock and utilize for picking up a ship and transfer it to the land. So the whole concept is, you have got, you got the floating dock here down below, and you see the ship here, it is on the land. So it is total ship is on the land. And then the ship is, I will show, conclude my talk by a small, you know, video graph. That is the animation. So there you will see it. The ship is sliced into pieces of, say, 1,000 ton to 1,200 tons. There again, by SPMTA, you know, that self-propelled transporters taken out to the next bay. You cut them into various panels, which will be about 125 tons to 130 tons. You got a 150-ton ELL crane, which can pick it up and give it to the next bay, where you cut, disintegrate, and subsequently, we have got a conveyor belt, we've got various cutter, multi-nozzle cutting system, and at the end of it, you are generating scrap, which is going into the steel mill, and this rolled steel is going out. And the other things which are not to be put into the furnace of the steel plant, that is a sellable product, which we have suggested that you do exactly what Along is doing. You make a godown, make a place, let the people buyer come all over the places, and they take it away. But your recycling is exactly the steel. This, what scrap you are getting out of the ship is excellent scrap. And incidentally, this scrap being of such a good quality, you can augment, you can increase your steel production by 50-50 addition of DRI. Now, cost of production of or generation of this scrap, this we are now talking about in terms of dollar. Now, I didn't mention that Hong Kong Convention, there is a commercial part of it, but purely technical issue is that scrap and DRI, that is sponge iron, two together you can get, and the further refining can be done in the ladle furnace, those, if you are conversant with the term, various furnaces. Ladle furnace where you can do the, we call it purging, all the gases which are in the molten steel. You can degas it, you can add certain further alloying element, and then you billet caster, then you got induction furnaces and through which you the rolling mill, and it will give the product. Product they are thinking about is TMT bar. It could be sections, it could be anything. Now, this is one plant, which one facility which we have designed, and the purely the concept is nothing is, no cutting, nothing is done in the wet state. This is the first concept which has been developed, and perhaps it is going to be implemented. And I foresee next generation of ship recycling yard will, once this facility has come up, I may be publishing paper on the subject, it will be more known to people, and people will be following the same technology or same process. You've got the, this is the a concept. We have been given a land of about 360 acres, of which about 180 acres we have shown is the facility, future land, further growth, and all that future expansion is possible. This is the concept. We have the ship, the movement, it is a rail transporter. This is nothing but a hydro motor drive on the tracks. This is a German gentleman sitting in Korea manufacturing it for the shipyards there. So this yellow objects are there. It has got jacking system, 400-ton picking capacity. So it pulls up. So a whole train of them are there. So three trains can be used for a 50-meter beam ship. Two trains can be used for 32-meter, that is Panamax size. So we have considered this, and incidentally, my client is lucky. He may be able to pick up a second-hand, good quality, good second-hand floating dock from Korea, because the Korean shipyards are not doing well. They are disposing of, their bankers are asking them to dispose of all the movable assets. So very cheaply, they may be able to pick up. So this is the slicing, as I mentioned. And after slicing, then, various stages, the various units and all that. The puck cutting, what we are, we have spoken to the manufacturers, they will give multi-nozzle puck cutters so that it is a semi-automatic process. One man, he is controlling the whole train of them. This is the steel making. Anyway, commercial part of it, we will not talk much. New. So this is where my life has been around, and very, very, I'm enjoying my life, because very professionally involved. I don't need to work for money because I've got enough. And I'm a retired naval officer, so handsome pension. So everything is okay for me as far as living is concerned. So enjoyment is to work with the budding young engineers, be their teacher, and coax them to do, and motivate, keep on motivating. And then, touch wood, very fortunate that the clients have got faith that yes, we'll be able to produce something which will work. Ultimately it must work. And story back, I go back in the, those who are the retired naval officers around here. Every one of you might have visited INS Shivaji, and you have seen the damage control training simulator. And that simulator is the same story when I was given the task, took the challenge, and we designed it. Then it was built. People were skeptical that will it work? And then when it worked, then everybody was with all the claps, yes. Commodore Mukherjee has done something, innovative design. But my colleague, Commander Deval, he was sent to UK to be trained on a similar system before he took over as an in charge of that establishment in Indian Navy. And he came back and he said that certain joint, which has seven different mechanical joints to give the transfer of fluid, water. You have to simulate damages. And here I had done only one swivel joint. And the system is still working. And this is where I call it, yes, you feel very happy, like a child is born, child grows up, and he becomes somebody. Similarly, all the tasks, the projects we do, and that's the engineer's pride.